Welcome to this video on different swing trading styles. These can be classified as discretionary and systematic style. After completing this video, you will be able to describe both the styles and differentiate them. Discretionary swing traders might define some rules to enter and exit a trade. However, as the name suggests, the trader might use his or her discretion over the rules to take or pass the trade. This decision can be influenced by recent experiences, by instinct, or by emotions. What happens when the rules are disregarded? As a rule, while driving a car, your tires should have an optimum level of air. Sure, you can drive a car with a flat tire, but imagine the damage it will cause. In a similar manner, consider a discretionary swing trader who has defined rules to exit if there is a loss of 8%, and not otherwise. But when you are putting real money in the trade, emotions can take over fast. You open a position and the position is at a loss of 5%. You are worried and you think it will go down by another 5%. And exit from the position immediately. But the stock reverses and increases 10% above your buy price. Thus, if you had trusted your rules, you would have been making gains instead of losses. However, discretionary trading has its own advantages. Sometimes the data available for analysis can be incomplete. And external data suggest limited chances of making a profit from the trade. And discretionary traders can use their judgment to trade better. Since the discretionary trader is required to make a judgment on each buy and sell decision, the trader is more likely to become emotionally attached. Human psychology plays an important part too. As demonstrated by the value function, you can see that people perceive gains and losses differently. While you will be a little happy with a $100 gain, you will be doubly scared when you hit $100 loss. Simply speaking, a loss hurts twice as much as the happiness you get for a gain of the same amount. Let's suppose you are richer by $500 than you are today. Now you are offered two options. Option A entails a sure loss of $100, and option B means a 50% chance to lose $200, and 50% chance to lose $0. Logically, if you take option A, you have restricted your loss to $100. Taking option B means you are risking more money just to have a chance to get back to zero. Although, when this experiment was conducted in real life, 64% selected option B. This shows that when it comes to losses, we tend to misjudge and become risk seekers. In contrast, a systematic trader relies on his strategy to make the correct decision. He defines trading rules and backtests them. He is confident in his trading strategy as he has validated it. This strategy is then converted into an algorithm using a programming language such as Python. The algorithm takes care of the entry and exit of a trade. Humans have limited time and brainpower. Thus, a discretionary trader is limited to trade in 2 to 3 securities. On the other hand, a systematic trader can scale his or her strategy to apply on hundreds to thousands of securities in different markets.